it's just a beautiful thing.
At HSPVA, from the time students walk into the building, they're encouraged to think outside of the box.
HSPVA is this beautiful, perfect little bubble where everything is fine.
At any given time, I can hear music. I can see people working at their art, trying to better themselves, and that's what allows me personally to really to let those creative juices flow.
I think it creates an environment where creativity can't help but be the most important thing in the space.
There's always something to see. Like, even if I'm in theater, I can always come see an art exhibit or go to a music show or a dance concert. There's just so many different styles of art and passion that are exhibited daily.
We teach our kids to take responsibility for their actions. We don't have bells at HSPVA. It's very much a free-spirited campus. One of the things that I think is a huge component of our school is that we have consultants or hourly lecturers on our campus who are actually professional working artists in Houston. And when I look at other art high schools across the nation, that's a component that they're not able to offer. So our students are actually working with and being taught by working artists in the community.
It gives you a chance to be musical and do what you do, but it doesn't have that structure. So it kind of allows the creative juice to flow and it lets you be you.
I have to fellowship with students of all different artistic backgrounds. I have to meet dancers, theater students, artists, in addition to vocalists in the instrumental department and people who just don't do the same things I do or think about things in the same way I do. And it's just a beautiful thing because it comes together so well.
When you come into the school, there's art everywhere, like this room. People come and they just spill out their creativity, and you can see things all over the school that just motivate you.
What allows me and inspires me to be creative is the environment more than anything, as it shows in my art and what I do academically. The environment's very welcoming, just overall, just welcoming.
If you just walk into the school, you can pretty much take a glance around at everything, and there's artistic energy all around us, no matter whether it's a painting or if you hear someone playing a piano, it all just kind of blends into one. So that's where I get most of my...
Yeah, I'd say the energy is really important, and you just walk in and you just feed off of it because everyone's excited about something. It's a really exciting place to be, and it's a really nurturing and comforting place to come to.
The most exciting thing to me about creativity in students at HSPVA is the fact that the students come here with a God-given talent, a talent that's unique to them. They learn what that talent is. Sometimes they don't realize what they have. Sometimes it's a passion already that they've developed. And they come here and they grow and evolve with that passion and with that talent in a way that is very unique. It gives them great self-discipline and security. And it fulfills them in a way that they become a more complete individual. It gives them more confidence, and it also helps them academically in their academic work because of the confidence. And they are more fulfilled than the average high school student because they get to do something that's very unique to themselves. Thank you.
think part of it, I think you probably agree, part of it is personal. The students take a lot of responsibility for that. You have to balance, because you have rehearsals all the time. Like, we have dance rehearsals after school a lot, and so you don't have as much time to do your homework or your projects, or you might not get to go to the movies after school. But I think it's worth it, because I don't know, I wouldn't want to not dance at school. And yeah, so a lot of that is personal, but then.
And a lot of it for me was just simply learning how to manage my time. As long as I knew how to be a dancer and get my academics done at the same time, then everything was fine for me.
I guess to do so successfully, you have to know your boundaries a little bit. You have to be careful that you don't go too far in either direction, or you'll sort of get lost and not be able to come back.
The two areas actually really help each other, because I know that people think, like, maybe with my area in particular, visual, it's very free and you don't really have many rules, but it's actually very structured. And the things that we learn there really help us in our academics, because you learn to schedule things and get things done on time and be productive.
That question is asked of us a great deal. How do we collaborate pleasantly in our environment with the academics and the arts? First of all, is a word called respect. All of us here at school, I think, respect one another greatly. The academic teachers respect the arts. They understand that the arts are 3 hours a day and are very important in these kids' lives. And then in the art areas, we very much emphasize the importance of academics. And since I've been here for 30 years, I've loved the fact that it's been a checks and balances, and the students know they must do well academically in order to excel artistically.
Delicate balance, I guess that's true. That's what art and academics are here in this space. But the first two words of the name of our school is still high school. We're still a high school, and students still have to be successful academically. And we have to remind them of that. And I think as faculty members, we have to be firm and help them stay focused on the fact that you still have to graduate from high school here. And the balance is a challenge, but I think it's also what helps them find a strength of character, because you have to develop a work ethic, a sense of time management, a sense of finding your priorities and finding the time to get to all of them. And I think it helps them become better people, because they look inside of themselves and figure all of that out.
I think because all of our art area teachers and our hourly lecturers or consultants are working in the area in which they teach, the kids are able to see the adults in the building be creative, and I think that encourages and helps our students with their artistic abilities as they grow.
Everyone's so supportive, and everyone's still critical and helpful, but they still remind you that you can do this, and like it's beautiful. I really can. I love this school so much.
When I came here, the teachers, the art area teachers, they really helped me find myself, and I just so I thank them so much for just letting me be myself.
I'd say there's an overall buzz just from all of the positivity, but more than anything, I think people here, as much as they respect each other, there's an element of competition between even your friends. And you know, even if it's not within the same art area, you find that you really have to like push yourself to show, even though everyone does show.
And like she said, competition, even though there is competition, it's a healthy competition. Yeah. It's not so much of, oh, I can do this better than you, or I'm gonna do this, or you can't do that. It's a matter of, we push each other. We're pushing each other to our limits through that competition. And as far as the school as a whole, we're kind of a small family. We may not know each one person individually, but we know who they are. We know who they are. And we all just kind of blend into this box of arts.
I think that that Ruth Denny founded the school on this trust, this element of trust, that if we will just trust that every student is going to come with this passion and this art, passion in their art, that all these other elements will fall into place. She really believed that. She believed that if we could just trust that that would happen, that we could find a way to work out all the details to make sure that it did happen.
We always have people who love us, and that has shaped me so much because it's so beautiful that people search their whole lives to find the place where they're supported and where they're happy and where everything is right, and this just is that place for so many students, especially for me, because of all the love.